Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to Serpros. In this video, we're going to be talking about firewalls, what they are, what they do, and also the difference between traditional and next-gen firewalls. So first, what is a firewall? If you drive or you're into cars, then you may be familiar with the term. If your engine explodes and catches fire, there is something called a firewall that separates and shields you from the burning hot flames. And network firewalls work in the same way. Let's take this basic network as an example. We have two hosts, a switch and a router. Because you, as a company, or as an admin, have control over these devices, policies, antivirus, etc., it's reasonable to consider this as a trusted network. But we have zero control over the devices and networks outside of our own, so it's fair to consider these as untrusted networks. Now, while most of the world is full of good-intentioned, trustworthy people, there are a huge number of bad guys out there looking to take down your systems and get their hands on your hard-earned money. With routers generally having minimal security features, you can quickly be at the mercy of the attackers. This is where firewalls come in. Firewalls are designed to shield and protect our trusted networks from the untrusted. The idea is that a firewall will block all of the bad traffic from the attackers, while at the same time, they'll allow normal flow for good traffic. So let's look at how firewalls achieve this. Most firewalls, by default, block everything. It doesn't matter if it's traffic leaving the network or traffic entering the network. Everything is blocked. The way we allow traffic to pass the firewall without being blocked is by adding something called firewall rules. For example, we may add a rule where the source is host A, the destination is any, because we're not going to add a list of every possible web server, and the port is HTTP or HTTPS. And we'll set the action to allow. The exact firewall rule format will vary from vendor to vendor. Now, when host A sends traffic, the firewall will see this and think, are you from host A? Yes. Are you going to any IP address? Yes. Are you using port HTTP? Yes. Okay, you are allowed. And it lets the traffic through. If host B tries to send traffic, the firewall checks its rules, sees that there are no matching rules, and blocks the traffic. So now let's add a rule for host B. Source, host B. Destination, any. Port, this time we'll choose any port. Not a recommended rule, but it will do for the sake of the example. Action, allow. Now both host A and host B can send traffic through the firewall. So that's traffic leaving the network. But what about traffic entering the network? Well, it's a good idea to block all traffic from external sources. The only exception is in special cases where you need to open up access for, say, VPN servers, email servers, and web servers. But if you do this, they should be tightly controlled by the firewall rules. But this poses a bit of an issue for us. Let's say we request a web page. The firewall checks our rules and allows the traffic through. At some point, that web server is going to respond, right? But if the firewall doesn't allow inbound traffic, what does it do? Well, most firewalls are something called stateful firewalls. Stateful firewalls monitor active connections. This means that once outbound traffic has been allowed, the returning traffic is then accepted. This is great because we don't need to add separate outgoing rules and separate incoming rules. Okay, so everything we've just discussed so far is known as a traditional firewall. It mostly uses firewall rules to block or allow traffic, based on a number of things like IP address, port number, etc. Now, next generation firewalls take the same methods, but then they enhance them with more in-depth security features. Quick warning, there are a lot of buzzwords out there, and next-gen firewall is definitely one of them. Different vendors will have slightly different meanings and features to what a next-gen firewall is or what theirs does, but generally speaking, this is what a next-generation firewall should include. Application-level inspection. So the firewall can identify and block risky application traffic. Intrusion Prevention Systems, or IPS. IPS will inspect the contents of the traffic and look for patterns or signatures. It's looking for malicious or malware-related traffic. IPS can also detect anomalies and unusual traffic. External Threat Intelligence. Next-generation firewalls can update themselves from external threat intelligence sources. So if a brand new attack has been identified, the vendor can update the firewall's threat intelligence to be able to identify this new emerging threat. There are a huge number of features that firewalls can offer. Things like URL filtering, email scanning, data loss prevention or DLP, and the list goes on and on. Firewalls that have features like these are often known as UTMs, or Unified Threat Management. The idea is you have a single appliance that unifies all of these security features. So that is how a network firewall works. But you may have seen another type. Computers can also have software-based firewalls. For example, the Windows firewall is built in and it uses the same rule-based methods, such as port, destination, and source IP address. So you might be thinking, why have a network and an endpoint firewall? I like to think of it like a house. If you lock all of your internal doors, would you be happy to leave the front door wide open and let the bad guys wander your halls? Probably not. Having a firewall both on the network and the endpoint is important when creating a layered security posture. If something gets past the network firewall, the endpoint firewall is there to catch it. Also, what if the attack comes internally? The network firewall doesn't see the traffic, but the endpoint firewall does. That's it for firewalls. This video is part of our full CCNA course, which can be found in the description. So please feel free to go and check that out. If you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, and subscribe. The support from you guys really helps this channel grow. Other than that, thank you for watching.